Alright, y'all, so Miss Elena, it's Michelle back at you again with another video. I want to show y'all my snake plant. I actually took this out of one of my large potted plants that I have, and I actually wanted to see if I can propagate it. And I know when you propagate these snake plants, you actually get different variations of the snake plant, the original one. So we're going to see. So if I propagate this all green snake plant, most likely it's going to be another snake plant with the yellow variations on the sides. So let's go ahead and get started. And when you cut these, you actually got to leave it in its correct order, because if you plant these upside down, you actually won't get any fruit. They'll die. And this snake plant here has been sitting in water. It actually has roots on the tip there, because I cut this off of the mother plant, and it actually grew roots. It took almost a year to get roots. I've been just letting it sit in water. I was trying to see if you could actually save a leaf cutting. And you can grow it right in with your water. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut it top. I'm gonna start from the top. But you know what, first I'm gonna get the flower cut. That it has plenty of peat moss in here, and it has a wonderful texture. It won't keep your plants too wet, and that's always a good thing
when you're having your plants growing in the house. Okay, so let me go ahead and put some soil in. Stick it right there, and I'm gonna go ahead and continue the process. All right, and start right here. And I better hold it, because I want to remember its place. You gotta place it correctly. You see, I'm gonna cut it right here. Now this is the bottom. This is the bottom here. If I go and plant that as the bottom, it's gonna die. You gotta make sure you keep it in its proper order, like I told you.
Alright, so there you go. Alright. Continue the process. And let me go ahead and hold it, because I don't want to lose the place. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and put this one in. And another thing, when you freshly put these in the soil, you actually want to keep the soil really damp so it can begin to grow some roots. Once it starts getting roots, it's okay to let it dry in between watering. All right. That's the bottom. That's the bottom. That's the top. We'll put that one in the middle. I probably should use another pot. Should I just all? Should I stuff them all in here? Maybe I'll just stuff them in here just because it's an experiment. I want to make sure it works, and I don't want to use all my soil. Even though it should work. And if I have to come across something that's dying, I'll just go ahead and snatch it out. No big deal. And once they start to grow, I'll go ahead and separate them anyway. So I'm going to
that one there. I might need to put some more soil in, because once you water these bad boys, you know the soil, it drops down. Trying to get you a nice view of that.
All right. And then we have this one. You know, this is the last, and this is also the top piece. I'm gonna go ahead and stick that. That's it, I'm gonna stick that in here. Stick that in there. Yeah. Press that down real good. All right, so there you have it. And like I said, once they start growing, it's gonna be yellow variations in the leaves, because that's just how it goes. Now, I heard a few people say that they actually did get the same variation, but that's very rare. So, yeah. But we're going to check that out. And, like I said, if you ask me, this one here is better than the, what's the brand again? The Miracle-Gro. I like this brand from the Rite Aid much better than the Miracle-Gro. Let me give you a close view. And I know one thing, once all the soil goes on sale at Rite Aid, I'm going to go down there and I'm going to grab so many bags of this, because it's cheap and it's wonderful. And I always put my own blends in the soil anyway, so it doesn't bother me that they don't have any ingredients in there. Hopefully. That you use hot water, because it actually encourages the growth, and it also kills any gnats or anything like that you may have in your soil. So that's that, and we'll keep an eye on this, and I will keep y'all posted. I am Miss Elaine, Miss Michelle. Peace out.